Hello and welcome to the feature of the week. In today's video, we will show you how to use Monolix and Simulix to represent the effect of covariates on the exposure parameters using forest plots, like this one shown here. We can use this type of forest plots to illustrate the effect of covariates or the probability of the typical subject's exposure to be inside or outside a specific interval of values. Forest plots present covariates vertically and displays certain effects and associated intervals for each variable. The effects are presented as relative to reference values, so the differences can be easily compared. On this forest plot, we can see the variables of interest, weight and sex, on the left side of the plots, each occupying a separate plot section. Each row within a section represents a different covariate value defined on the left axis. The blue circles represent the effect of the covariates, Cmax relative to the reference, and the associated horizontal lines are the 90% confidence intervals of those effects. These confidence intervals are the consequence of the uncertainty we have on the estimated population parameters. In this example, the reference is a male subject with a body weight of 85 kilograms. The dashed vertical line represents the reference ratio of 1. This forest plot shows clearly that the extreme body weight values of 128 and 56 kilograms have an important effect on Cmax, while sex does not. Let's focus for a moment on the effect of sex. Here is how a PK profile of a typical reference individual, a male subject, looks like. And here is how a PK profile of a typical female subject looks like. By typical, we mean that the random effects have been set to zero, such that the individual parameters include the population value and covariate effects. We can compare the Cmax values of these two profiles, and we can see that their ratio plotted on the forest plot as a blue circle. Now, we simulate these profiles using the population PK parameters estimated by Monolix. However, these parameters are estimated with some uncertainty, which is captured in the standard errors and correlation metrics of the estimates. To take this uncertainty into account, we can simulate several profiles with different sets of population parameters. This results in confidence intervals of a PK profile of a typical female subject and typical male subject. We can use results of these simulations to calculate the 90% confidence interval of the ratio of Cmax and present these results in the forest plot as the blue line. This is how to get plot data for a particular covariate. If multiple covariates are present in the model, they are changed one at a time, while fixing other covariates at the reference values. To create forest plots using MonolixSuite, we will follow these steps. First, we will export a Monolix project to Simulix. Second, create covariate elements, one for the reference and others by changing values of one covariate at a time. Next, set up and run a simulation. In the outcomes and endpoints, post-process the simulation results to calculate exposure parameters Cmax and AUC as outcomes. And finally, we will switch from the graphical user interface to R to generate the plots. Let's start by opening a Monolix project. This Monolix project consists of a one-compartment model with linear elimination and first-order absorption with T-lag. As you can see, it has two covariate effects. Weight is a covariate on volume of distribution, and sex is a covariate on clearance. I've run the population parameter and standard error estimations. It is important to run the standard errors estimation to include uncertainty on parameters after exporting the project to Simulix. We now export the project to Simulix. Simulation elements are automatically created based on Monolix runs. The element MLX typical uncertain SA has random effects set to zero and includes uncertainty on fixed effects. We will use it in simulations. We need to create covariate elements to use in the simulation. To do this, we first need to decide the reference values for covariates. For categorical covariates, the reference is one of the categories, and for continuous covariates, we typically use the median value of the observed covariate distribution. In this case, we will choose 0 as the reference sex and 85 as the reference weight. Next, we need to decide for which values of covariates we want to assess the impact. For continuous covariates, we calculate the effects at specific values. Usually, those are the 5th, 25th, 75th, and 95th percentiles from the observed covariate distribution. For categorical covariates, we use all categories available in the dataset. For example, we will choose weights of 56 and 128 kilograms, and for sex, we want to see the impact of value 1 compared to the reference value of 0. We will now create the covariate elements in Simulix. First the reference, and then we duplicate the reference elements and change covariate values. Usually, forest plots show the effect of covariates on the exposure parameters such as Cmax and AUC. We can calculate AUC using the additional lines option in the model section. Then we create an output element with the variable AUC. Next, we create a treatment that we want to simulate. For example, a single dose of 100 mg. Next step is to prepare and run the simulation. We create 4 simulation groups, one for each covariate change. So we first assign the right covariate element to each of the groups. Then we will select the created treatment element and elements that output concentration in AUC. Remember that we want to take into account the uncertainty of the population parameters and the typical individual. So we select MLX typical uncertain SA. We set the number of replicates to 1000 because one set of population parameters is sampled for each replicate. Within each replicate, we want to simulate only a typical individual, with random effects set to 0, so we set group size to 1. We can then run the simulation. This plot shows the concentration time profiles for typical individuals with different covariate values with uncertainty on the population parameters. Next step is to post-process the simulation results to get Cmax and AUC. We will create one outcome element to calculate the Cmax and one to calculate AUC and run the outcomes and endpoints task. In the plots, we now see the distribution of Cmax and AUC over replicates in the form of box plots. We would like to present this information in the form of forest plots. To do this, we will use the results of this Simulix project in R and functions from the ggplot R package to construct the forest plots. This R function accepts a Simulix project and an endpoint name and creates a forest plot. It works in 3 basic steps. It retrieves the results of a Simulix project, it formats them, and then plots the forest plot. You can find more information about the usage of the function and you can download it using the link in the description. We'll now source the function and run it twice. One to get a forest plot for AUC and one to get a forest plot for Cmax. In the next feature of the week video, we'll show you how to tweak the steps presented in this video to create several other types of forest plots and how to automate the whole process using LeakSoft connectors. Thank you for watching and have a nice week.